The next speaker is someone who always introduces himself as a community ninja. And I don't know what that means, but apparently there is a position like that at Mozilla, and he is the voice of Mozilla in Poland. He will tell you about the software that will be shaping society of the future. Please welcome Zbigniew Wranicki.
All right. Hello, everyone. So, I'd like to ask for 5 minutes of your time, and I'm going to talk about software, and it's going to be very vague and overall, but those will be just four major tips for you related to software and how it will impact our society. So the first part is I want to talk about business and politics, because I think that both are displaced by software these days. Not replaced, displaced. Business, it's easy. Everybody knows what's going on. With politics, most people think, come on, it has nothing to do with software. Actually, it has. Because when politics ignores software, software is starting to govern our life in the areas where politics does not. So coming back to business, business is obviously shaped by software. And if you look at top 10 companies in the world, or in US at least, the top 10 most valuable companies, 5 of them are software companies. But the more interesting one is like Walmart or FedEx. Actually, you can start thinking of them as software networks that apparently just have some trucks and buildings and planes, but mostly they are software networks. That's how they build their position. You can think it's about like cars. How much of modern car is software? How much it matters? It matters more than hardware, because like wheels and steering wheel and engine, everyone has it. So business of these days is run by software, and if you want to evaluate a company, you have to look at its software stack, especially if you want to invest money. Really, worth it. So business is obvious part, but the little bit less known is politics. And I want to talk a little bit about how politics is kind of ignoring software. So if you think about our government, the topics for the elections, we have elections now. There will be nothing about software, maybe except of we'll give you laptops for free. But what actually happens is that our life is moving to social networks, is moving to internet. And as it's moving there, what's going on the internet matters more than what's going on in politics. No government of democratic world can hope to have an impact with a single bill as Apple can have if it ignores or rejects Google Plus app for iPhone. So if you want to think about politics, I recommend you now just skip politics. Really, it's not worth it. You will not impact human lives on a level you want to. But what you can do is just go to Facebook. Or start a new social network, or Twitter, or whatever. This is the way you can impact how people will live in the future. So we talked about politics and business, and as I said, those are just tips. But now I want to talk about society and software. With society, the interesting part is that as we move to online, we are shaping the way we live, because we can write software that runs our life online, which means whatever you want to do in your social life, there is an app for that. But the flip side of that is that however you want to think about who owns the app or who owns the software stack, suddenly can impact your life. And it can impact your life in a very direct way that never happened before. So think about what would happen if Google would change its algorithm for searching. What would happen if Facebook changes algorithm for how it sorts and displays on the wall. Suddenly you meet with different people, you talk to different people, you learn different ideas, you find different websites, and suddenly software or the algorithms for this software run your life and can impact it in a very nasty way, rearranging your social life. So if you want to build society or impact society or shape it the way you want, I recommend creating apps. This is probably the best way to do this today. But creating apps and writing software historically has been a dominant platform of big companies. For most of the history of computers, except of the beginning, you can think that huge companies with huge R&D and whatnot came up with new software. Microsoft, Google, Apple. But if you think about the themes that are important today and what will really burst or ignite in the future, like health, education, software that changes how we run our lives and how we make money, I don't think it will come from big companies. The reason why it will not come from big companies is because they are too strict. They care about revenue. The software that will shape our lives will come from amorphous forms that are capable or possible on the internet right now and are fluid in a way that our creativity is fluid and are hard to tax. So governments can have no impact on that. So if you want to see what will come next, I'll recommend looking at GitHub or Reddit or Bitbucket, not at Wall Street, Microsoft, Google, or Apple. So four tips I wanted to give you. If you want to evaluate your business or if you want to invest it, look at the software stack. If you want to govern people, go to Facebook or Twitter. If you want to build society, write apps. And if you see what's next, look at GitHub. Thank you very much.